Right, right. So it's actually, you really feel the location. Like say, you can smell some of these.
Yes, it's amazing.
The garbage dumps and the slums and the busyness and the frenetic and the kinetic and the real visceral quality of life there. I mean, that's, I think, the most astounding thing about the filmmaking. Every frame, you know, you just turn away from them and you turn back to the frame and you look at it and you say, what an incredible composition that is.
Yes.
I mean, foreground, background, busyness, and it's, you know, highly edited, beautiful editing. As well.
Oh yeah, the there's that kind of dichotomy between those style, you know, that kind of you know, the opera. There's a lot like between the mythical part and then the style, the form.
Right.
And so you get, you know, like for instance the that opera, Gluck opera, when it was kind of revolutionary.
Mm.
It was the first opera that sort of, not the first, but it was in a French style that sort of broke from the Italian style that was very complicated, very ornamentary. Mm. And they went back to really kind of the, you know, the action, the simplicity of music, of singing, and then also dance. And you get that in a movie, too.
You do, and that's what really throws the whole thing into this mythic space, because they do the Bollywood dance at the end of it.
Yeah, they sort of mix it all up.
How are you thinking all these characters, putting them in a train station, now they're all going to dance? And you sort of, it's just absolutely right for the movie.
Yes.
Partly
it
at that
works.
Level.
It's really well glued together, and you come out like you can't. So the story didn't matter to me when I came out of it. I was starting to think of everything but the story.
Right. All of the little details of fate
The clash of culture to, you know, how you get this, you know, when they're showing some part of the culture, the emphasis on the Three Musketeers and, you know.
Well, that's the one I was going to bring up, the story style of the writing of the Three Musketeers.
Yes.
Alexandre Dumas,
right.
Who you were saying was actually...
Alexandre Dumas, it was also kind of a revolutionary work.
And the florid style of that storytelling is absolutely...
It doesn't stop, and you are getting these up and down. All, and there's also kind of a humor element to it, which is also in the movie.
Horrific, but very funny, and not necessarily trying to move you up and down, it's just both are embodied all the time. It's florid.
Yes, yeah. Hmm. And so, to me, that really adapt well to that clash of culture, because, you know, you get he's doing what he did a little bit in Trainspotting, Danny Boyle. Is like it shows you this kind of horrific, the kind of stuff that, from our point of view, Western point of view, horrifies us, or you know, we recoil from it, like the you know, the slums, feces, you know, like the whole things that you can smell and
feces
taste.
Again, as in Trainspotting, somebody
right,
has to go down into the. Can we say shit on the web? Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
And comes out of it and
is
almost found time to release.
You know, he's really grasping on this and then you get, that's the kind of stuff that really takes us by the, you know, we recoil from it, and is bringing this whole story, you know, that on the other side, that you know, we that is actually kind of amazing, is really refreshing.
Yeah.
And so out of that, he's able to bring this story, just like Orpheus, just like Alexandre Dumas things, kind of really a winning story.
And then there's can't help but think of Dickens. It just felt like Dickens to me. You've got the children, the beggars running around, blind beggars, and they're being led by, you know, evil forces, and you've got the gangsters,
right?
You know, who are running the children, and it's just one of those little plots that moves around the bottom.
Yeah,
yeah.
And also, and this is also, you know, there's a kind of a sense of humor.
Mm-hmm.
So it's never, it can be really dark, and it's really.
And when you say class of cultures, though, and you say all of these different elements, it also is. I think I was reading somewhere, really a global movie.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
He's
for that.
Irish, and this is in, you know.
Now, you know what? I think
is this a foreign film? I don't know what a foreign film is anymore.
Right.
Because this is so neatly woven together, not only in the storytelling in mythic styles, but in the production itself and in the languages.
That kind of style, though, is probably less surprising for a European audience than us. I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong now.
Uh-huh.
But I think this type of a cultural, bicultural or some approach is probably a lot less striking to especially English audience.
Mm-hmm.
And probably European audience.
And so maybe we ought to be getting used to it over here, and it'll break us out of that sort of hegemony of movie stars and standard plots and standard special effects that sort of excite us and titillate us with our own filmmaking, and open it up to.
And there's been already kind of a few films like, not in that style, but more kind of the Indian style mm-hmm. of movies that mm-hmm. have.
Well, even Lost in Translation, which is Wong Kar Wai meets Sofia Coppola, which I thought was one of the first sort of stunning multi-cultural movies.
Definitely.
With Bill Murray, so everybody will still go.
With a lot of subplots mm-hmm. too. You can sort of.
But this is one of the best that I've seen. Most exciting films I've seen
definitely.
In terms of how it weaves all that together.
Oh, it's well put together, and I haven't. Obviously, I haven't read the 12 story that is the screenwriter took those stories from.
Yeah, no.
So it was, I can't remember the name of it now. It totally escapes me. But it was taken from a book that has 12 different stories, mm-hmm. and so I don't know how different they were. But the screenwriting is brilliant for that because it's really it got it all together really nicely, and yet you can come out of it with kind of all those different things
swirling around in your
head. Yeah, even
and
though
you walk out of the theater sort of looking at the world a little bit.
Right. But the movie is just straight on.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
It goes, it stops right in the middle, like that scene that I was talking about, but that's the only time.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just right through.
Yeah.
And so it's, it's striking. It's really well done.
I think it's going to do incredibly well. People are really anticipating seeing this, and if it wins a Best Picture nomination, I don't know if it wins Best Picture for a foreign film or what the category is anymore.
Yeah,
maybe we have to revise that.
One little thing, so people will see it.
Yeah.
Maybe they want to go see, or I think you can even see it on YouTube. Is a movie called Black Orpheus.
Oh, of course, yeah.
And by Marcel Camus, I think.
Yeah, yeah.
And at the end of that movie, and it's a story of Orpheus, mm-hmm. but reinterpreted. And at the end of that movie, there's a scene where the guy, Orpheus, in the movie, I can't remember his name in the movie, but he's sitting there, that's the end of the movie, and they really follow the myth.
Mm-hmm.
And he's there with two little kids. And that's the end of the movie. And he has these two little kids. And then a woman walks by and give them a rose. And so when you see that with this movie, after or before seeing this movie, I think like this.
There's no doubt Danny Boyle has seen Black Orpheus. It's a classic. And it was actually re-released a few years ago with a new print because it's so colorful.
Yes.
You don't want to see it on YouTube because it's so colorful and the music is so rich in Black Orpheus. It's all music. It's almost a musical.
Right,
this constant drumming and
and it's a Caribbean. It's a different type of action.
Yeah,
but I think it kind of ties it up.
Put the two together.
It's a pretty pretty.
A night, a recommendation for a night at the movies from Sean Doe. Well, thanks, Sean Doe.
Yeah,
great,
thanks.
Great. So
thank you again.
Go see Slumdog Millionaire and see it at the Coolidge Corner Theater if you're on the East Coast, and we'll see you there.